Business Leadership South Africa and its division, Business Against Crime, is worried about where we are as an economy. I think that's the first point of departure. So you know that our economy is currently characterized by low growth. So you therefore have to look at what is the some of the contributing factors to the low growth situation that we're currently facing. And we have looked at it and said that there is a lot of leakages that you actually see in the system from a public finances perspective, you know. And if we were to actually arrest this scourge, then you would actually start seeing the low growth situation turning. So I'm actually talking about the fact that illicit trade is a big contributor to the strain that the fiscus is currently experiencing. So we know that we're currently bleeding about 250 million rands a day that is lost in tax revenues, you know, as a direct result of illicit trade. We heard Minister Tito Mboweni, for instance, during the budget speech, talking about the fact that we have had to revise down our tax revenues that we're expecting to get in 2020 by 63 billion rands. It therefore means that if government doesn't have this money, then it's going to have to go out there and borrow it somewhere. It puts a further strain on the fiscus because that debt is going to have to be serviced. And if it's going to have to be serviced, it therefore, you know, means there is less money, you know, available in our coffers for us to be able to do the things that we really need to do to start turning the economy around. So it might have a direct impact just on the tax revenues, but I guess there is a broader domino effect, you know, that it actually has on the broader economy. And if the economy is impacted, then business is impacted as well. So I think it was about time that business leaded, you know, or led this discussion in as far as illicit trade and the impact thereon on the economy, and try and come up with ways in terms of how to actually deal with it. So the overall impact of it obviously is that, you know, it robs legitimate businesses of revenues that they can be actually getting. And if legitimate businesses' revenue is impacted, it means that the tax that they actually pay, you know, to SARS and to the government is actually lessened. If the tax that is paid to the government is lessened, it means that the tax revenue that we have as a country is less. If the tax revenue is less, it means that there is less to go around, you know, in the country in the form of expenditure, in the form it impacts on service delivery and each and every aspect of our lives, you know, as South Africa. That is the impact of it, you know, and that is why it actually has to be arrested. And I think one of the biggest findings that we actually saw come out of the report is the track and trace, you know, our solution to say that should we not start to follow some of these items that are actually sitting on shelves of some of these shops, you know, to see where they are coming from, you know, so that you start arresting it from where the problem begins, right? I think we had earlier on, we're talking about packets of cigarettes that are being sold for 10 rands, you know, when the tax on cigarettes is 20 rand 1 cent. So how do you therefore, you know, have a packet of cigarettes that is sold for 50% less than what the tax is? So it's clear that that is an illicit product, and you know, the manufacturer therefore is not paying taxes in as far as that product is concerned, and that is how the fiscus is therefore robbed, you know, of tax revenue that it can actually be getting. And I think the second one, probably some of the findings that came out, is maybe we should actually strengthen the inspectorate, you know, at the factories, shop floors, where these products are actually being manufactured, so that you actually see how much is being manufactured, and you can start gauging, you know, to say that how much is available in the market versus what is being manufactured. And if too much is being available on the market versus what is being manufactured, then you actually start seeing that there is, you know, products that are actually coming in that are not being accounted for from a manufacturing perspective, and we therefore start dealing with that. But, you know, from a business perspective, this highly impacts on our manufacturing industries, right? Not only manufacturing, all the industries that are actually impacted, right? And it therefore leads to the joblessness that we're sitting with as a country. South Africa is currently sitting with 29.1% unemployment in terms of the narrow definition, and in terms of the expanded definition, it's 40% unemployment. You know, you have more people that are unemployed than those that are employed in all the provinces except Gauteng and the Western Cape. And the problem keeps on getting worse. When you're looking at youth unemployment, you're sitting at about 56% unemployment. It cannot be. How are we going to begin to arrest the low growth situation when you have so many people that are actually sitting out of employment? You know, it's highly problematic because it exacerbates the poverty problem that we have. We have more than 50% of our population that are actually living in poverty, you know, and it therefore, you know, just makes worse the inequality problem that we have. So I think we therefore have to start looking at what are some of the reasons, you know, in terms of why we're sitting where we're sitting as a country. So it's all good and well to be looking at unemployment, poverty and inequality, but I think you would see that these things, if not arrested at their basis, you know, because it's no use dealing with a symptom, which is the poverty. You actually need to deal with the root. And one of the biggest roots, you know, in the South African perspective is definitely the illicit trade in terms of how much it robs the fiscus from a tax revenue perspective. It's a function of awareness, because I don't know if people realize what the domino effect and the impact that it has on them as an individual and their household and their community when they actually buy these illicit products. Because I think a lot of these products, we buy them knowingly. Right? And I think that is where the problem is. And I think because there is that demand, you know, from the community, the supply side therefore continues to grow. So these people that are engaged in illicit trading are actually encouraged to produce more, you know, because they've got a market, as it were. But if you buy these illicit products, it therefore means whatever it is you're buying doesn't find itself to SARS, because you and I know that most of the goods and services that we buy are vettable, and that VET contributes to the tax revenues, you know, which go to SARS, which therefore, you know, are actually contributing to the broader fiscus. So if you're buying such a product, it therefore means there is no tax revenue contribution. If there is no tax revenue contribution, it means that there is less tax revenues, you know, available to government. If there's less tax revenues, it means that there is less government expenditure. Government expenditure is actually spent on building schools, you know, building hospitals, you know, hiring public servants, you know, nurses, teachers, whatever the case is, the spend on education, the spend on trying to curb the poverty that we actually see on the country, the spending on delivering houses, you know, the spending on ensuring that the water is available. So you can actually see it actually, there are so many touch points, you know, of how government expenditure actually affects all of us, because all of us are actually users of public goods in some way or the other. You know, I don't care how elite, you know, of a person you are, you still have to drive on some road, you know, that the government has to maintain and whatever the case is. You know, your dustbin has to be taken out by the municipality, which is a function of government. So that is what the impact of it is, you know. But I think the more dire impact is that you are therefore taking these companies that are legitimate traders, you know, from you actually taking them out of business. And if they are being taken out of business, it therefore means, you know, that there is job shedding that is actually happening, because, you know, legitimate goods are not being bought at the levels that they are actually supposed to be bought. It therefore means that these legitimate companies end up producing less. And if they are producing less, it therefore means that they need less people to actually produce these goods and services. If they need less people, it therefore means that they have no choice but to actually, you know, retrench. And if they are retrenching, that is how it actually impacts people on the street. You know, they are sitting without jobs, they've got no disposable income, they are dependent on grants, and which is a further drain on the fiscus. So it actually has that direct impact from a job perspective, but from a public goods perspective, as I've just alluded.